Hello you all. Welcome to this new edition of Lexio Musica, the place for great lyrics, great music and great meaning. My name is Guylain Prince. I'm a Franciscan friar from Canada. I love rock music for a long time, especially hard rock, metal and prog. Once a week, I listen with you guys to one song. Most of the time, it's a new song for me. Not this week, though. Enter Sandman from Metallica. We celebrated this year the 30th anniversary of the whole album. And it was, so 1991 was impossible to escape for anybody listening to music. For once, I would say, especially in our area, a metal song was known by non-metal fans. It went further than I would say the regular listeners. Enter Sandman is a special song for the band itself in the history of rock. No wonder. When Metallica decided to do a 30th anniversary album, asking for a lot of people to do whatever they wanted with their song. All very famous people contributed to that 30th anniversary album. It's quite a, I would say it's quite an accomplishment, I have to say. I've listened to it. Most of the time, I find the Metallica version, of course, much better than those who try to do something. Sometimes I found the versions interesting. But brace yourself, because in the case of the warning, we are talking about recreating the song. So this video will be a little bit different. Not much to say about the lyrics. I will say just a few words after listening to the original song by Metallica. So we will listen 30 years later. I haven't seen that video, never. I know the song, never seen the video. So I'm really interested to see what did they put in the original video of 1991. So the shape of the video is, you will recognize the shape of older screens. After the song itself, I will say a few comments on the content of the song. And for that, I will give myself the screen with the lyrics. I prepared that. I won't put it on the on your screen, though, because I will just say a few words, basically. And after that, we will listen. We'll treat ourselves with the beautiful... We will go back in time with the warning when they were little girls. Yes, they did a video of Enter Sandman. They were girls, little girls. And it became viral on the internet. I think, as we speak, I think it's close to 30 million views on YouTube. So the warning has been this song. The original version has been quite an accomplishment for them, quite a start, I have to say. So it will be very interesting. I'm still looking for the numbers. The original is 23 million. For now, let's go back in time, 1991, with this great classic by the band of the time in metal. Some liked them a lot, some didn't like them at the time. Found that they turned a little bit too much commercial, some kind. I don't care about all this. I don't. What I care is the quality of the song. Let's dig in the 1991 Enter Sandman official video of Metallica. Oh my lord, a lot of flanger.
on acoustic guitar. Oh, drum. Well recorded. Efficient. Famous riffs. The video suggests the presence of the musicianship. Love it.
Yeah, that works. Yeah, really, that still works. 30 years after, it's not an old song. Not at all. Not at all. Excellent. Excellent song, really. Now, it's up to the, I would say, up to the reputation of the song. And enjoyed it. Yeah, enjoyed it very much. Now, let's go through some of the lyrics, because most of the lyrics are quite clear, to be frank. Say your prayer, little one. Don't forget my son to include everyone. These lyrics are famous, as the fatherly figure comes close by the bed. And don't forget to do the little prayer, and don't forget to include everyone. So I'll talk you, in warm, and keep yourself free from sin. Have good thoughts. Do your prayer until the Sandman comes. So, but then the pre-chorus, sleep with one eye only, gripping your pillow tight, after comforting the child, you say, well, yeah, I was asleep, but sleep with one eye, and get your pillow close. So it's a mixed message. This song is a mixed message. Part of it is like a nice, comforting message and lullaby, or comforting message before the night comes of someone who is a protector. But the protector doesn't stay much. I don't know if it's the same person or another person comes and say, well, but be careful. The night, there is something in the night you should be. So, yeah, the little boy, I'll take care of you, I'll protect you, I'll take care. But at the same time, be careful. So this ambivalence of the song is pretty much present in the video. You have both the little boy, the nice little boy, and the possibility that there's something might happen during the night. Let's go. So exit the light, enter night, beginning of the night, take my hand, Sandman, enter Sandman. He comes, take the hand, and like Peter Pan, brings us to Neverland. But here, Neverland. What is Neverland? The phantasmagoric world, beautiful world of Peter Pan, might be replaced with a land of nightmares. What do you think? What do you get of Neverland? That would be my take on this one. Neverland. That's how I understand. Okay. Something's wrong. Shut the light. Heavy thoughts tonight. So the child is, or maybe the adult, is feeling heavy. Something is, there's either a tension, there's something wrong. It's not as usual. And the thoughts of tonight are not those of Snow White. We understand that. They are dreams of wars, dreams of liars, dreams of dragons, friar, bad dreams, and of things that will bite. Yeah. So sleep with one night. So the Sandman do not bring the child to Neverland. He brings it to Neverland. I think it's not a good place for the child. It's not experience. It's experience as a scary place. The experience of being scared in the night, in your dreams, bad dreams. Now I lay me down to sleep, pray the Lord my soul to keep. This is a child's prayer. I've seen that. I don't know where. But basically, I'm pretty sure this is an already existing prayer for children, yeah. And I want you to take me, Lord, with candor, with with pure heart. So take my hand, take my soul, keep my soul. And if I have to die, but take me, I want to be with the Lord. That's the prayer we have here. But there comes back, is it the Sandman talking to the child? Little boy, don't say a word. Never mind that noise you heard. It's just the beast under your bed. So it's not, the two first line, they sounded like it's reassuring. It's not, it's not. It's just the beasts under your head, your bed, in your closet, in your head. So they are beasts. So that might refer to the heavy thoughts that we have in the second verse, and the heavy tonight, ever thoughts tonight. So bad dreams. So yeah, yeah, that's that Sandman brings the kid not to a great place. That Sandman bring a grain of sand. I don't know if you say that in English, but in French, a grain of sand will make a mechanic do the mechanic not work well. That might refer to that. That, of course, the itchy eyes of a little boy, a little girl, there's as if there were sand in their eyes. That's the origin of the Sandman, kind of letting go a few grains of sand so that the child, they want to sleep. Yeah. So for the rest, we're off to Never Never Land. So I would call it the anti-Neverland, where there are adventures, there are dreams, but they are not good dreams. And to the little boy, instead of from one hand, there is, yes, from one side, there are reassuring message to the child. But on the other hand, there will be big nightmares, there will be heavy thoughts, there will be bad dreams, okay? So it's a kind of a ambivalent song. It's not all bad, it's not all scary, it's not all, I would say, blue and pink little ponies, no. And I think that's the secret of the song. The song is a kind of not a lullaby, not reassuring words at bedtime, but at the same time, there are bad things happening, and the Sandman will bring you to these bad things as well. So the experience of bad dreams. I find this song, because it doesn't have a monolithic or one-sided perspective. That's what I love. That's why I love this song. In terms of writings, I love the writing. It's not a fancy writing. It's not fancy poetry, but it's well written. And of course, the unforgettable riff combined with the melody, which is quite it's not a rich melody, but it's an effective one. It works. Sometimes you glue even a simple melody with strong word, it makes a great song. This is a great song. Part of it comes from the wonderful riff they created for that song. Part of it is for the lyrics, the ambivalence of the lyrics. And the combination of the two makes it a haunting song. And this is what haunting song for haunting lyrics. And this is a great, great song. So now that we've seen what Metallica did, let's go back in time, but not as much as 30 years back. At the beginning of the 2014, This is 7 years ago. That would be 2015. I made a small mistake. There are three little girls playing metal music. Three little girls at the time that nobody knew. Not in North America anyways. Maybe in their country they were known. Maybe some people knew them already. I remember 7 years ago somebody sending me that video. He said, oh my Lord, those little girls are, at the same time they were saying they are cute, but at the same time we were amazed by the quality of the equipment they had. Yamaha drums for me, because they were the drums of Jeff Porcaro, of Toto, were always close after Tama drums. They were very close second or third in terms of sound. These drums, I remember saying, oh my Lord, that's a great drum. And the equipment they have, look at the pedal panel of the guitarists and so on. And look at the basement. I think the basement is bigger than, look at that, it's unbelievable. She's so small because, of course, the one who is the bassman, now the tallest, but at the time she was so young. She's, is it 17? She just turned 17. So bring this back, 17, rewind 7 years ago. That means that she is 10 years old, the bassman there. So let's see that video that made so many people amazed by these young musicians. Let's see it. The warning, cover, Enter Sandman. Paulina already has authority. Girls playing that. Hey, Daniela has already long fingers. She has very long fingers. She can do chords I cannot do physically. Oh, nice. Nice view. Solid Ali, solid Alexander, Alejandra. She even has the wah-wah pedal. Does she? Yeah.
There it is.
Sandman teaching the prayer to the little one. Very close to the original, isn't it? Wow. Well, that was a funny one. Oh. They are all timid. They don't know how to behave in front of the camera, apart when the music is gone. That's great. That's absolutely great. Oh, my Lord. They've been, what can you expect? They've been very faithful to the original. Apart from, we can see once in a while that the guitar riff is just a little bit slow, but all in all, it's a very solid. The drummer, I can't believe, she's so much have authority, she cannot be moved from the stool of her drums, you know, she will stay there. And she will play, and she's all small, you know, but she plays with a lot of authority. She is sure of herself. I don't know if she is in terms of a person, but she is as a drummer, of course. I was surprised how Alejandra was, my Lord, very good. I mean, I'm surprised are clear, the notes are precise, and there's no hesitation. And some of the runs are a little bit intricate, you know. Some are very simple, but others, they're, you know, little elements that are. Of course, in there, she's so small, but in there, Daniela is the one that had to work. She had to work a lot because she plays both the rhythmic guitar, and then she goes for the solo part as well, which of course can be done by two different guitarists. There are two guitarists in the recording, and she does it very, very well, and the singing and all this. So that was 7 years ago, but as I told you, last fall, there was the publication of the 30th anniversary album. A lot of musicians. There's even country version of Song of the Songs. And it's very interesting to hear how people take a song, a famous song, and make something different out of it. I have to say, it's not because I did a series on the warning. But I have to say that most of the time I don't find the album that creative. I think that the respect the artists have for the songs, for me, is so strong that to a certain degree they don't go as far as I would have expected. Some were really recreated, done beautifully, but some of them are simply a cover song, not necessarily much better than the one done by the little girls. So I was a bit disappointed overall, I would say, of about 30% of the songs of the album. But some of them I really loved. So now my question for you. Why the team of Metallica, maybe Metallica themselves, I don't know, who are the one to decide? Why they chose the warning? And it's Alessia Cara, if I remember, Alessia Cara, and the warning version to open up the album. The first song, when the people put the CD or when they listen on the streamer, the first song they hear is this. Let's see what they did with that song. 3, 2, 1. The three little girls. And the tall one in the middle is the bassman, Alejandra. Alessia Cara, a pop singer from Canada. Another world. Sleep with one eye open, gripping your pillow tight. Exit light, enter night. Take my hand. We're off to never, never land. Oh. See the size of his head. So choreographed. Completely in another world. For you this? No, I don't think so. Never mind that noise you heard. It's just the beast under your bed, in your closet, in your head. Hush, little baby, don't say a word. And never mind that noise you heard. It's just the beast under your bed.
Brit, Daniela. What a great location, eh? Yes. Oh, yes, a few remarks about the song. The drummer now, have you seen the size of the snare? And it's the first time, no, maybe in Disciple, Paulina is often in front of the beat. She is pulling the whole band forward. Just a bit before the beat itself, now she is behind it, so it gives an impression of a burn, especially the riff, the ending riff. As usual, the choice of sounds from Daniela is first class. Wow, she gets the tone. The tone of her guitars are always well selected. She has a lot of taste. I don't know if it's only her doing or her in dialogue with the producer. Love it. The voice of Alessia Cara is the soft one. She brings the dimension of a lullaby. And then when they want the grit, they ask Daniela to sing. Their voices, the girls' voices, it's very nice. A creepy prayer by Paulina in the middle, supposed to be a nice prayer, this, and she looks like coming out of a scary movie of some kind. And again, Alejandra, the tall one, the youngest one, she appears to be singing, at least in the choreography of the video. I don't know if she sings really on the album, but as usual, there's something about her in terms of presence. I will say the quality of her presence, visual, and she is not overdo it. She's just herself, but I would say we talk in communication language. Cameras love her. Why we say that? It means that even if you take a general point of view of the whole band, naturally the eyes will go towards Alejandra. The way she walks, the way she behaves, the way she plays her guitar, and sometimes we can't even see that she's timid in a way. She's not all that, I would say, extrovert kind of bass player, but there is something in her way, and of course Daniela is the passion, is the one that will bring the whole passion of the song, the music, the riffs she plays. Now, let's talk about the construction of the song. They chose, that's a very interesting and unusual. What is it that makes this song so great is the riff. So you start the riff and everybody will say, enter Sandman. It's with the drum beat. Yeah, the beautiful drum beat. Oh, and she's... isn't she Paulina up to
to the quality of the legendary. It's a legendary beat, the one of Enter Sandman. The beat, the quality of the recording, the sound of that drum, wonderful. She's up there with him. We lose nothing of that quality. But they chose to keep. That's an interesting choice. I would say it's a not only creative, it is audacious. What makes this song famous is the drum beat with the riff, and you don't have it at the beginning. So basically, it's a recreation of the song. I think that these ladies, they took the lyrics. They understood the lyrics. They say, okay, instead of making the opening with that gorgeous gorgeous riff that's legendary, we'll make it the explosive final. How explosive was it? It was wonderful. So they kind of bet on recreating the song based on the lyrics. They made it a creepy lullaby, a creepy, scary lullaby, or I don't know how to say that, to be frank. It's supposed to be reassuring, but it's not, you know. So I think they got the essence of the song. They recreated something great. And from my point of view, just my opinion, it's the best of the 30th anniversary of the anniversary of the album of Metallica. For me, that's the most original, the real, a real, for me, to do a homage to a song is not to do it exactly the same. Literally, they took the lyrics, they took some lines, melodic lines, they rearrange everything so that the song, there's a build up towards the crescendo of the end. And instead of betting on a money making opening with the riff, they decided to make it the summit at the end. To me, this is brilliant musicianship in construction. I'm very proud I did those 7 videos of the warning. Yep, I can tell right now I'm a fan. I will follow their career if they continue as they are on the same. I wish them as much faithful fans as the band Rush had for 40 years. They retired when one of them died. 40 years of great, great, great music, faithful to each other, even when one of them had bad problems. They all hold their career for a little while, for 2-3 years, and then they came back. I wish them long-term fans, because I want to follow these beautiful, talented, incredible musician of the Warning. I will be there. So see you next time for probably the next song. I don't know when they will come out, but I'll be there with reactions to their new material as well. For now, congratulations, the Warning. Your EP is great, and this video and song is ingenious as much as it can be. I totally agree with Metallica. That's the one I would have put first on a 30th anniversary album, commemorative album. See you next week. We begin a new series on a rock opera by the artist from the Netherlands, Arion. I don't know if it's the right way to pronounce it, but it will be. We will do a whole album. I know the name of the album, but I want to keep the surprise for most of you. This is prog rock with a side of metal. It's the who's who of the singers in metal, in rock. Great singers, great interpret. It's opera, but rock opera. Be there, you don't want to miss it. Beginning next week, Bye bye for now. Bye.